Hello friends, this is Dr. Nidhi Sharma, Associate Professor, Department of English, Swami Keshwanand Institute of Technology, Management and Gramothan, Jaipur. Today, we are going to study a topic of human values entitled Understanding the Basic Content and Process of Value Education. So friends, before commencing with the topic, let us take a look at the present state of our society. Friends, we all are aware of the numerous advances that have taken place through the use of science, technology, management, and medicine. But if we talk of our society in a broader perspective, what do you think? Has our society also advanced towards the desired state? Okay, for instance, let us consider the predominant factor of fear around us. What do you think? Which type of fear makes us more vulnerable? Is it the fear of the natural calamities, the fear of the wild animals, or the fear of the inhuman behavior of the fellow human beings? Friends, today there is a constant increase in the levels of stress in the individuals living in society. There is stress related to the divisions in families, terrorism in society, exploitation of nature by nature, climate change, global warming, etc. In such a scenario, what do you think? Is the education imparted to us contributing positively or negatively to this? If we talk of the current scenario, do you think the students develop a mindset of sustainable production and right utilization? Or do they just develop a mindset of accumulating subject-related information and indulgence, of course, with a minimum labor? In whole sum, if we talk of this state of our society, what do you think? Does it increase or decrease the fear? Okay, now let's come to the most important terminology of our lives, that is success. Friends, what do you think? Is success achieved only by earning money? Or is it attained by getting a decent degree? Or do you think it can only be achieved by grabbing a prestigious job? Do you think education should prepare you to be successful? Well, these are some thought-provoking questions that demand a brainstorming session of discussions. And if we talk of education, then what are the expectations from education? Friends, as we all know, the fundamental criterion of education is the responsibility to facilitate understanding and learning. This term understanding can be defined as the knowledge of what to do, meaning what is valuable as a human being. And the term learning means how to do, that is, how something can be associated with an individual's skills and the techniques of using technology. We already know that both are very important for our existence. But still, can you decide what should be the priority between these two? Okay, now let's come to the next part. Now we have come to the main topic of this video lecture, why value education? Friends, value education is extremely important in today's time because it enables us to understand what is valuable for human happiness. It is all about enabling a transformation in the human beings to help them move from animal consciousness to human consciousness. This study of value education is supported by the various guidelines that it imparts through the following points. For instance, the study of value education should be universal, means whatever is studied as value education needs to be universally applicable to all the human beings and also be true at all the times and all places. It should not depend only on the sect, creed, nationality, race, or gender. Second point is that it should be rational, meaning it should be properly understood in all its totality by the respective receivers, and it should not be based on any kind of blind beliefs. We all know it's so important to protect our sanity and rationality in today's testing times. Thirdly, the most important task of value education is to verify the values by checking one's own experience and available evidence. For example, if we take the case of a student, then he or she should not be asked to believe something only on the basis of what is said or stated in the course. Rather, he or she should be encouraged to verify the details. And the last point is maintaining harmony. These values should enable us to live in peace and harmony with our own selves as well as with others. Because it's only with the performance of coexistence in society and nature that we would be able to survive in the present ecosystem. Now, focusing on the content of value education, it should be noted that the understanding of content covers all the four dimensions in an individual's portfolio, comprising of his thought, behavior, work, and understanding. Friends, the famous psychologist Sigmund Freud had once said, "Give me a child and I will make him do what you want him to become." Now, here him is not gender specific, it's neutral. The four levels in society include individual, family, society, and nature. The detailed study of these levels can be studied in the next chapter, discussing harmony at various levels in our society. Going further to the process of value education, we come across six important points. The first point states that the process of value education is universal, meaning it's the same irrespective of its time, place, or individuals. Secondly, it's rational, as it appeals to the logical human reasoning. Thirdly, it's natural, as it is acceptable to all the human beings, and there's always a provision in nature for its fulfillment, eventually leading to its verifiability through one's own natural acceptance as well as experience in living. And finally, it's all encompassing, that is covering all the aspects of human existence. Friends, coming to the last slide of this video presentation, we have an extension of the process of value education entitled self-exploration, where the term exploration means observing outside and self-exploration means observing inside. Hence, summing up the two lead to the process of finding out what is valuable to us by investigating within ourselves. We should constantly be aware that whatever is said is only a proposal. We shouldn't assume it to be true. On the contrary, it should be taken up as a dialogue that starts between the two and finally becomes one with our own self. This natural process of self-verification and experiential validation leads to the concept of right understanding, which will be studied in the upcoming chapters. So friends, with this, we have come to the end of the topic. I hope I could properly condense the topic on value education for all of you. Let's call it a day. Wishing you all the best. Thank you and happy learning.